Welcome to the Michigan Golfer Show. Join us each week as we explore the people, the places, and the events that shape our great game.
Hi, Mike DeVries. I'm here with Meg Mallon at the West Michigan Golf Show, old friends, and here to talk about a little bit about architecture and what you find on the tour, and or found on the tour and found out now, and what you like about architecture or not.
I'm fascinated about architecture and how you guys think. Sometimes you're a little sick, but sometimes you're amazing in what you come up with. And it's fascinating to me now, especially later in my career, and appreciating how difficult it is to put together a golf course and what you. I'd love to know what you guys are thinking when you're doing it. Because, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think probably the shaper is one of the most important parts of your process, right?
Absolutely. And it's all part of trying, for me, it's part of trying to find what's fun and how do you create fun golf shots.
Right, and challenge.
And what makes you think? What makes the golfer think?
Right.
And if you can get them thinking, particularly the high-level player,
yeah.
If you get them to choose from two or three or four different types of shots, at least I have a chance to beat you because you're too good.
But let me ask you, who are your favorite architects that you learn from? Like for me, I love Alistair McKenzie, I love Donald Ross, and some Seth Rayner courses too are really cool. So I love that style of golf, and especially the green complexes. So did you take from that or learn from that?
Certainly, yeah, all the old guys, uh-huh. The old dead guys we call them, from the golden age. But McKenzie's my favorite.
Brilliant.
Having grown up at Crystal Downs, that's obviously a big influence for me. And but I've worked on Donald Ross golf courses, Seth Rayner, mm-hmm. Walter Travis. So lots of different architects, and that's super fun because you learn stuff.
Right.
For me, that's kind of archaeology. You're investigating. You're peeling back the layers,
and you get in their head. You're no different than competitors, because we learn from the people before us as well,
and
develop our games, you know, based on what they're successful at as well. So that's good. It's a great game.
It's a lot of fun. So we've had a lot of fun playing up at Kingsley and at the Downs and stuff, and some fun matches and things like that.
I know.
In fact, I think I remember us taking on Beth Daniel and Fred Muller taking them down.
That's a fun thing to do, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Especially Fred. Beth doesn't talk too much after a loss, so that's not fun. But Fred does a lot of talking.
He still chatters.
he does. He's a great guy, and he's been a great friend, and as you know, been very open and welcoming at Crystal Downs, and it's the gem, I think, in the state of Michigan, and of course Kingsley Club has been, you know, wonderful in making me a member there, and it's such a great unique track that nothing you would ever play before in the country, really. So it's, you know, I don't play much golf, but I got two pretty good choices up there to play.
Tell me what of, you know, all your great victories and things, what of those courses was really excited you as far as just playing, not necessarily just winning the tournament, but what inspired you and what inspires you?
That's a great question, because I grew up in the Detroit area, so I actually caddied at Oakland Hills when I was 14 years old, so right away I saw what beauty is and what a golf course should look like, and so I got so inspired by our major championships because the golf courses were just so much better that, you know, we played, especially the U.S. Opens.
Yeah.
So when we'd go, you know, play Colonial, you know, you knew you were playing a fantastically designed golf course.
Right.
So I just get that much more excited to play.
Yeah.
And, you know, a lot of times, you know, you play for 20 years on tour and you're playing kind of the same mundane golf courses over and over again.
Yeah.
You know, that's what you don't understand, the difference between the men's and women's tour. The men are playing Riviera, Colonial, Pebble Beach, Augusta National. You can't name off golf courses like that for us. I mean, we're fortunate to play, but it would be really nice to play the great ones.
So when you get to a major,
you're playing those great golf courses around the world. Now we play the Women's British Open on pretty much the same venues the men do. And it was towards the end of my career. I wish it had been more in the beginning of my career, because I got to play Turnberry and the old course and these fantastic golf courses over there. And it just really got me excited to play.
Different conditions, different shots.
Loved it.
Loved it.
You have to adapt. Your short game has to, you know, be sharp, and I just love it.
Well, thanks. It's been fun catching
up. Mike, thank you, and good luck with your projects as well.
Thank you.